Muhammad Ali died on Saturday. In the wake of his death, Donald Trump made a tweet which got many progressives' panties in a twist. Apparently, calling Ali a great champion and a wonderful guy was offensive. Shortly after Donald Trump made his obligatory tweet, Huffington Post jumped on the chance to call Donald Trump a racist, or something. But here's what struck me most about their article. In the article, they talk about how Trump wants to ban all Muslims, which isn't true since Trump has said that there would not be a ban on Muslim American citizens, and the ban to non-American Muslims would be temporary until we could figure out a safe way to vet them. The reason for the proposed ban? According to a survey released by the Center for Security Policy, 25% of Muslims in America believe that violence against Americans here in the U.S. can be justified as part of global jihad. Even better, 51% want the choice to be governed by Sharia law rather than American law. Trump cites these very statistics on his website. Sharia law, in case you don't know, has a lot of fun perks, like men can marry up to 4 wives at once, slaves are legal, and a husband can dissolve his marriage by simply saying, "I divorce you." These perks come with some caveats, though. Like, if you cheat on your husband, you'll get stoned to death. If you're gay, you'll get thrown off a roof. And if you're a woman, it's especially fun. You have to have a man go with you everywhere you go. In most Muslim countries, you can't drive. You must have your male guardian's permission to leave the house. A woman can't have sex outside of marriage, even though men can. Your husband can beat you if you do something he doesn't like. You can be married off to a man in some countries as young as 10 years old. You'll probably get circumcised. If you're on your period, you can't go to a mosque because your period is impure, and you should really just stay in your house during that time. You have to cover your hair as a sign of modesty, and in some places, you can't show any part of your body outside the home. But those are just small concessions to make. Really? Anyway, so Donald Trump wants to try to protect the country by stopping Islamic migration and taking a minute to consider if allowing just anyone into the country to live off welfare and not contribute to the economy in any way is the best idea. Donald Trump said, "Without looking at the various polling data, it is obvious to anybody that the hatred is beyond comprehension. Where this hatred comes from and why we will have to determine. Until we are able to determine and understand this problem and the dangerous threat it poses, our country cannot be the victims of horrendous attacks by people that believe only in jihad and have no sense of reason or respect for human life." Sounds fairly reasonable to me, but of course, Huffington Post disagrees. So, upon Muhammad Ali's death, they took the opportunity to again attack Donald Trump instead of honoring a dead man. Real classy. Before I get to the issue between Trump and Ali, you need to hear a quote by Ali from a 1971 interview. And the best part is, I got this information from another HuffPo article. In 1971, Muhammad Ali went on the British talk show Parkinson, and while there, he said something that still rings true today. But maybe not about the group you're thinking.
There are many white people who mean right and in heart want to do right, but there are so few. If 10,000 rattlesnakes was coming down that aisle now, and I had a door here I could shut, and in that 10,000, 1,000 meant right. 1,000 rattlesnakes didn't want to bite me. I knew they were good. Should I let all these rattlesnakes come down, hoping that 1,000 get together and form a shield? Or should I just close the door and stay safe?
So, all white people are racist. Remember this feminist analogy? It's the same general premise, and it stands true for all of the not all statements. You can't tell who's a racist, who's a misogynist, who's a terrorist, etc. So you treat them all as if they were. Maybe Muhammad Ali should have thought of that interview when he said this regarding Donald Trump's Muslim immigration policy. "I am a Muslim, and there is nothing Islamic about killing innocent people in Paris, San Bernardino, or anywhere else in the world. True Muslims know that the ruthless violence of so-called Islamic jihadists goes against the very tenets of our religion." Not all Muslims, you guys. Come on. It can't be yes all men, yes all whites, and not all Muslims. So the truth is, Ali was a racist. And a hypocrite. Am I happy that he's dead? Of course not. I'm never happy when anyone dies, and my thoughts and prayers go out to his friends and family. But regardless of his life status, it is important to know that maybe the boxing legend shouldn't be looked to for thoughts on policy. Make your own opinions, liberals. Stop using celebrities who can't remember where they stand. I leave you with another quote HuffPo thought was very exemplary of this black Muslim athlete. And if this isn't inciting violence, I don't know what is. I can't read it because it has a word that I'm not allowed to say in it. Have an opinion? Leave me a comment below. I'll never delete comments and I will reply to as many as I can. If you have an idea for a story I should do or you just want to get a hold of me, tweet at me at littlemissskeptic and follow me on Twitter for updates and opinions about news, politics, and general tomfoolery. If you like my videos, please consider becoming a part of the skeptical family. Your support is so important right now in getting these questions and facts out there. We can't let the leftists bury the facts and push emotion before logic. Please share my videos with anyone you think might enjoy them and urge more people to support those of us who are trying to expose the truth and logic in the world. Thanks for watching!